That tour was really interesting, don't you think?
Yes, I do. A week has passed since Judge Maxwell was present.
Forget what happened, and I'll make sure the people responsible get what they deserve.
Hello, everybody. Patsy here. Welcome to Criminal Archives, City on Fire by Domini Games. So this game was released last week, on Tuesday, I believe. And I didn't even know, guys. So I was only expecting Thursday's release, that was a Christmas Wonderlands. So I didn't know this game was released last week also, a second game. And so here we are, we are playing this right now, today, Monday night. And also, I don't believe I have played the beta version of this game. We are playing this for the first time right now. So here we go, let's check it out. And the reason why you're seeing this game right now is because of the sponsor of the channel, so thank you, sponsors! Want to take this time to thank every one of them, including Moderator Ray, Chris Bowman, Sofia42, Lucas Oliveira, GamerGo Detective, Blaine Mayo, Muster1, Laurie Lin, and Sassy Sissy! So thank you everybody for supporting the channel. Alright, here we go guys, it's time to play. Criminal Archives, Sea of Fire. Are you writing a book? It's a report.
Hello, this is Barbara. There were several murders in our city recently. Please go to the last crime scene and get information for a news article. Oh, and don't forget to take some pictures. I've already cleared it with the police. Constable Melinda Watson will meet you there and tell you about the case.
I think that's Miss Watson. Need to speak to her. So this is a crime scene. And I see a fire engine there. New task, take a picture of the body. See the body right here, guys. Miss Watson asked me to take some pictures. The tripod is already here. So where's the camera? There's some kind of a mark on his palm. Like an hourglass with wings. Is it a tattoo? So scratch marks on his legs and arms and hands.
Hello, I'm Melinda Watson, the local constable. Our whole department thinks you're the best crime reporter out there. Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you too, Miss Watson. Sorry I kind of ignored you just now and went straight to the body. But hello.
Your photos and articles have helped a lot of our investigations. I was told to give you the information we have on the previous murders. Please, look over these documents. You can help me examine the crime scene once you're done. Could you also take some shots for the police? I'm going to write up a report for the chief in the meantime. Here, you'll need this.
The case files. Thank you, Miss Watson. Alright, let's look at what the police have. Top secret. Case number 638. Several people were murdered. Local construction foreman Harper Morris, he had a strange hourglass mark, and journalist Vivian Phillips, oh, the one on his palm, on the victim, right in front of me, the same one. So two victims so far. Does that include the body that we are seeing right now? Now, it will be easier to navigate in the city with the map. The murders were committed at night at the homes of the deceased. All the victims died from stab wounds. In all cases, the killer left notes warning that this was only the beginning, and they wouldn't stop until the last culprit was killed. Culprit? Okay. He's calling his victims culprits, guys. That's interesting. The killer strikes again. The victim is Darren Sanders, the head of the fire department. He was killed at his house. The building was set on fire afterward. Okay, so that's the opening movie. And I think we are seeing the right... And I think we are seeing his body right now. Darren Sanders. What connects Mr. Sanders with the other victims? The tattoo? Maybe. Unusual mark. That could be important. Okay, bonus item. Okay, protect my hand using the handkerchief. Some kind of a badge. It's a fire badge. Firefighting emblem. My task book. Some currency. Notebook. Now I can make a to-do list. Oh, Donnie, guys. We broke the key. What a bad start. Magnifying glass. My hint. My hint glass. Okay, using our emblem. Magnet. A clip. Looks like a clothespin. A very expensive clothespin. Not your normal wooden ones. So let's head back to the lock chest using our clip. And here's our camera. My crime scene camera. It's ready for operation now. Abrasions, bloodstains. Judging by the number of bloodstains, the victim was stabbed multiple times. Obviously, the murderer has strong animosity toward the victim. Multiple times? At least three times? Then we have the fingerprints, but bloody fingerprints. The bloody fingerprints. Note pieces. The knuckles are bruised and the scratches are fresh. No doubt the victim was defending himself. But those are scratch marks. Does that mean that the murderer has long fingernails? Or maybe it was a cat? Claws of a cat. I will keep on killing until there's no evil. I will keep on killing until there's no evil. This city will be cleansed by fire. So that's the reason why he was setting fire to all the places, guys. And here is the mark. It is the same as on the previous victim. So these people were killed by the same person. So are you telling me that the killer used a stamp on the hand to put the signs on the victims?
Hey, are your photos ready? If you give them to me, I can send them to the department lab.
Here you go.
The fire is completely out now. You can go in. But honestly, there's not much left in there.
All right, let's examine the scene. Please, bring me any clues you find, and we'll look over everything together.
Well, hope springs eternal. Maybe something has remained intact. Examine the evidence. All right, let's go in, Miss Watson. Into the burn house.
Now we can investigate the house. Please, help me look for some evidence. This will be good material for your article.
She's right, I need more facts to write a really sensational article. So, see burnt carpets. Only this particular spot. Oh, trapdoor, guys. Try our ribbon. Or the magnet. It doesn't work. It's not strong enough to lift the lid. How about a belt? Leather belt. Can move the latch with something thin. Or something magnetic. Ignore the rule, guys. Oh, it doesn't work. Never mind. The box, did not burn. An ornate box. Interesting shape. Should look for something similar to open the box. And here is a metal ruler. Hey, let's open these cabinets. Pictures of firemen, a fire truck, to the best chief from his team. The team really respected Mr. Sanders, who would have a grudge against him. A stack of books. Oops. I need to lift this up again using the bolts. Oh, what is this, guys? Fuel? There's evidence of arson. A broken bottle of fuel. And there's leftover inside. Yeah, we need to do a test on this. Now, it seems like the vase is the only beautiful thing that survived this horrible fire. It is so close to the edge of the table, guys. I'm surprised that it did not fall over. Okay, leave the crime scene. There's something out here that we have not done. Use our lockpicks. Lower the pegs above in the correct order by setting the right sequence of actions for the lockpicks using the arrows below. And press the triangle to test your combination. So this is hard mode. And we do have the sequence right here at the bottom. So... one, two, three. Lower the pegs above in the correct order. Huh. Let's start with the one arrow first then. Okay, that opens up the first lock. So that's the correct one. So I guess I need to try an arrow this. Okay, this will take a while, guys. How about one? One and one. Okay, one and one is correct. One, one, two, two. Oh, okay, that one is wrong. 1, 1, 3, 2. Okay, all the other ones are wrong then. So let's do all twos. All wrong. How about threes? Yeah, I think they were all at one. So now all threes. Okay, this one is wrong. One and one. This one is a two? It's got to be a two then. The only option left. Finally! Broken cutter and a ring! That is for the trapdoor. Very durable handle, guys. So, a stash of money? Why would a rich man hide his money at home when he could keep it at bank? That is a bit odd. And there's something inside the crack. An emblem. Winged emblem. A plague doctor seal. Maybe this was a threat. So our arsonist was also wearing a plague mask. We saw him in the opening movie. So those are the evidence pieces. We got them all. Miss Watson.
Well done. I had some luck too. I found out the fire wasn't an accident. Someone disabled the fire alarm. Maybe that's why the firefighters arrived so late. Let's compare our evidence to get a better idea of what happened.
Two heads are better than one. Now make all the potion colors according to the instructions. Press two containers and then press the center beaker to mix them. Okay, so I see the list here. So all these colors and symbols are on the table, right? So combining the first two like this to get red color. Are we getting red? Click the bottle. Okay, we got the first two. But it's not working, guys. Oh, you need to press the bottle here. Press the beaker in the middle. And now we got the red chemical. Okay, next one. Press the bottle. That's yellow. Blue. Purple. And orange. Green.
Almost every home used to use this liquid for fireplaces and lamps, but it was discontinued for being too flammable. Where could the killer have gotten it?
Assemble the picture, select a fragment, and then select the picture outline to place it. Fragments turn green when positioned correctly. Okay, so... Okay, this is easy mode. Let's play on hard mode. Hard mode does not have the background picture. But at least now we know what it looks like, guys. It's the plague mask killer. Okay. I guess we cheated, guys. We saw the hint on the easy mode. But even without the hint, this looks pretty simple. Am I right? Okay, that piece is wrong. And I made a mistake. And we are done now.
Despite these threats, Mr. Sanders decided to deal with this on his own. He was definitely hiding something, and the killer blackmailed him.
The city is soaked in corruption, permissiveness, and selfishness to the bones. but I'll put an end to it. I'll completely change this city, and I'll start with you, Mr. Sanders. But he's not the first victim, guys. There was also a woman who died, according to the article that we saw earlier. Find the differences. hard mode. Okay, so there's 7 of them. Hey, numbers are correct. The currency is wrong. 1,500. It's a different man. the missing badge. The angel. Okay, actually not the angel. She's holding different items on her hands.
Mr. Sanders liked keeping his savings in a bank. He wouldn't need a pile of money like this.